Hello, good morning children. Due to unavoidable circumstance, we are not able to meet each other. So, today I am going to explain Standard 5 Social Studies first lesson, Maps and Globes. About maps and globes. So, our earth, what is the shape of the earth? The earth is round like a ball. It is also called spherical in shape. And about 71% of the earth's surface has water that we can see on rivers, oceans, seas, etc. And that is why the earth is also called the blue planet. And 29% of earth is of land area where we live. Now, the large land masses on the earth are called the continents. So, what are called continents? The large land masses on the earth are called continents. And large water bodies are called oceans. So, what are called oceans? Large water bodies are called oceans. So, how many continents are there, children? Do you know? There are 7 continents. How many continents are there? 7 continents. And how many oceans are there, children? There are 5 oceans. And which continent do you live, do you know? We live in Asian continent. We belong to Asia. Then there are 7 continents. They are Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Europe, Australia and Antarctica. Which is the largest continent, children? The largest continent is Asia. And which is the largest, smallest continent, children? Australia. Australia is the smallest continent. Now, the 5 oceans are Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Arctic Ocean and Southern Ocean. So, which is the largest ocean, children? Pacific Ocean. Which is the largest ocean, children? Pacific Ocean. Then, which is the smallest ocean? The smallest ocean is Arctic Ocean. Now we are going to learn about the globe. What is the globe? The globe is a small model of the earth. It is round in shape. What I have explained now, the notes are already given in my video. Please go through it and learn properly. Next, we are going to learn about the globe. The axis is an imaginary line which passes through the two poles of the globe. Means from here to here. Suppose this is a globe. And this is an imaginary line which passes through two poles. Means from north to south. The top part of the globe shows north pole. This portion is, suppose this is a globe. This portion is north pole. And this portion shows the south pole. This is bottom and this is top. Top shows the north pole and the bottom shows the south pole. Now, what are the merits and limitations of the globe? As you know that globe is very big, it is difficult to carry. Globe is the best way to see the correct shape of the earth, location and size of the continents and oceans. Then, what are its limitations? Means it is the merit of globe that it is the best way to see the correct size and location and size of the continents and oceans. Now, what are the limitations? Limitations, you know that it is very difficult to carry with us. Now, we can see only half of the globe at a time. If we want to see other part, we have to rotate it. Now, it cannot show smaller towns, landforms, details of the city or state. Suppose if we want to see another part of the continent, we have to rotate. Then, it cannot show smaller towns, landforms, details of the city or state. Now, next we are going to learn about the map. Map you have already seen, children. Means, Now we are going to learn about the map. What is map? What is map, children? Map is a flat drawing of the earth and or part of it on a flat surface. What is map? Map is a flat drawing of the earth on a flat surface. Now it shows continents, countries, cities or neighborhood. Now the word map came from the Latin word mapo. That means napkin. Napkin, you know that, no? We can fold the napkin. So the word map came from the Latin word mapo. Now who is called a cartographer? So who is called a cartographer? One who makes the map. That person is called a cartographer. Now what is called cartography? What is cartography? The process of making map or the study of maps, that is called a cartography. Children, what I have explained to you now, that is already given in my note. Please go through it and learn properly. Now, merits of maps. So, you know that the map is easy to carry. What are the merits of map? The merits of maps are, it shows size and shape of countries and distance between places. The map shows the distance between the places. And it shows smaller area with greater details. If you want to see any smaller area, you can see it clearly on a map. Then it is easy to carry. You know that, no? Wherever we go, we can take the map with us because it is very light. Now it shows location of different features like mountains, deserts, forests, etc. If you want to see all these places, we can see in a map very clearly because it shows the particular areas clearly. Now, what are the different types of maps? You know that you have already learned in class 4 also, children. What are the different types of maps? The different types of maps are political maps, physical maps, spatial maps, road maps, weather maps, maps of the city, etc. People use these old maps for different purposes. Now you have already learned in smaller classes also, how many directions are there, children? Do you know how many directions are there? There are four main directions. They are east, west, north and south. Then to study the map, we need to know the direction, all these four directions. So these are already shown here, north, south, west and east. If we stand facing the map like this, suppose a map is shown here, we are standing. If we stand facing the map, the top part of the map shows the north and the bottom shows the south. And the right side shows east and the left side shows west. So you have to face like this on the map and then we can see all the four directions. And a map always shows the north as N. It will be written at the top part of the map. It will be written as N in big letters. So that is called a north. Once we know the north direction, it is easy to find other directions. Then there are four sub directions also. Means all these four main directions are there and at the same time there are four sub directions also. And they are northeast, northwest, southeast and southwest. The short forms are of all these are northeast means NE, northwest NW, southeast SE and southwest SW. Children, what I have explained to you now is already shown in my video. Please go through it and learn properly. Now the next topic we are going to learn is scale of a map. Means scale, all of you know that, no? Scale, how it looks? means all of you know it, the scale is already in your hand also, that is called a ruler. Means, but every map is also got a scale. Every map has a scale. It looks like a ruler. The map's scale is also looks like a ruler. What is scale? But in the map it is different. The scale is the ratio between the actual distance on the ground and the distance shown on the map. So it is called a scale. The scale is the ratio between actual distance on the ground and the distance shown on the map. Now you are next going to learn about conventional symbols. It is not possible to show all the features of an area in their actual shape and size. So we use symbols to represent natural or man-made features on the earth. So many times we use symbols to show something, because every time we cannot show all the things in detail. So we use symbols like river, bridge, road, etc. We show in very small form. That is called a symbol. Now, a symbol is a drawing, line or dot that stands for something else. The symbols on a map are called a conventional symbol. So, what symbols we used on a map, that is called a conventional symbols. Have you understood, children? What I told? Conventional symbols. Then, different colors are used on a map to show different things. So, many of you are having crayons with you. So, we use different colors to mark different things on a map. So, like blue color shows water bodies, green color shows plain areas, brown color shows mountains, yellow color shows deserts, dark yellow or light brown shows plateaus. So, when we learn about map, we have to bring crayons. You have to bring crayon and you have to mark different places with different colors in a map. Now, what is the use of a compass? Have you heard of compass, children? In smaller classes also, 3 also you learn, 4 also you learn. So, what is a compass? A compass is an instrument that is used by sailors to find the direction. And a compass always, it has a needle and the point of the needle always shows the north. And the sailors used it. So, this is an instrument used by sailors to find directions and its needle always points to the north. So, children, I think the first lessons, almost all the explanations are over. I think you have understood this. Now, I am giving you some extra questions for learning. And you have to learn page number 12 and 13, what is given in your book, first lesson. Fill in the blanks, answer these questions. All those things you have to learn properly. And here are some extra questions for you. Like define, continents, block, cartography, compass, scale of a map, directions. Now, some short notes. This merits of block, types of maps, symbol. So now these all things you have to learn properly at home. You at least 5 times you read your book every day and find out all the answers and write also 5 times in your rough copy. Children, I think you have understood this lesson. So thank you for listening.